everyone. Hope you're doing well and are safe in your homes. My name is Preeti Rao and I'm founder of Wellgy. Today, we're going to do another asana that will be simple for you to do at home. For this asana, you would need only two props. You would need a scarf or even a dupatta that you can find from your home, okay? Anything that's in your home. The second thing that you would need would be a small cushion. Even your pillow that you use to sleep on, that will also do. So these two props, one pillow and one scarf or a dupatta would do for this asana. So the asana that we're doing today is called Supta Padangustha. Okay? Supta means lying down, Pada means the foot. Angustha, like angutha, means the big toe. Okay? For this, you need to lie down once again. So make sure you keep your prop handy close to you. So you sit down comfortably on your mat, on your dadi, whatever is available in your home. And with your, make sure your back is absolutely straight, your shoulders are rotated backwards, your chest is up, and you're looking straight in front of you. Now slowly, maintaining the core strength, you're going to lie down on your back. Okay? Now that you're comfortable, place your arms by your side. From this position, you raise your legs up. One leg up. Extend, so this is your right leg, okay? So you're extending this leg. Release the left leg on the floor, okay? You're right here. So for somebody who is absolutely beginner, you can be right here. If this is also too difficult and you can't even open your toes, open your legs wide, so you take this scarf, bend it into two, put it behind you, the center of your foot, and use this. Okay? Now, make sure your knee is not bending. Your leg is absolutely straight. If you're comfortable, you can pull it closer to yourself. So you should be able to feel an absolutely beautiful stretch in the backside of your leg, in your calves, and also in your hamstrings. I also wanted to talk to you about why this asana is very, very beneficial for you. So this asana is very beneficial for you because it helps you with osteoporosis of the hip and the knee. As you can see, it helps me to lengthen the hip joint and also the calf muscles. Okay, now from this position, you can release the neck, one arm. Okay, so in this case, the left arm, release it on the floor. Now from here, bring it to the side. So if you have this pillow right there, so this can anchor or support you. So this would be for somebody who's in beginner to intermediate level. Now if you're even more comfortable, so you can release, let go of that pillow. Okay? From here, you can go down all the way to the side. Now the other benefit of this asana is it helps you during menstrual cramps, okay? It helps you with less bleeding, cramping, so it's really, really great and beneficial in that period of the month. So doing this regularly will regulate your monthly cycles. So you're right here. Now if this is also very easy, you can make it even more advanced. You release the scarf, okay? Grab hold of the big toe, extend it up, and bring it to the side. So stay here. You're now feeling a big, nice stretch on your hamstrings and your calves. The beauty about yoga is holding the asana as long as possible. This asana, as you can see, also helps you to strengthen the back, elevates, you know, releases any back pain that you may have. So very beneficial for people who are complaining of backache. So when you're here, now, you can release the hand and release the leg and slowly bring it back down. Now you can repeat the same thing on the other leg. Okay? So I hope you've understood. So whenever you're getting up from the mat, so it's always better. So either you come to the side, make a pillow with your hands, or come up, or you can rock and come up like I showed you in the previous video. I hope you enjoyed this asana. Make sure you use the benefit of the props and gradually progress your practice. Take care. Ciao from my side. Take care. Have a wonderful day.